Welcome to Strathclyde's Methodist Circuit's worship this week. Welcome to those who are using the transcript and those on the telephone as well. This video was created and is brought to you for your worship by the Knit and Natter Group.
We now meet on a Monday morning for an hour and talk about and share different crafts that we're all interested, be it sewing, knitting and art and whatever. I myself was never much of a knitter, but we took on, it was knitting for teddies, as it was a buddy bag foundation. It was knitting teddies for a charity, but I really quite enjoyed it, and some others did that too. It's great to have to hear from everyone and hearing how God inspires in all the things that we do and make, and as well as supporting a good cause. It reminds us that God uses us, all our talents, and that ordinary people can make to do extraordinary things. It's a simple way. In a simple way, I forget about the cares of the day and restrictions which affect us all in our mind and spirit. And now I'll hand you over to Joanne, who is lead us in prayer.
Lord, I thank you for my hands, for all the things I can do with my hands, all the things I can make, all the things I can grow. Things that will feed my family and feed me. I think of the hands working all over the world. Healing hands, making hands, hands reaching out to other folk. And I thank you for the talents that people have that involve their hands. Thank you for the group and the Knit and Natter for all their talents, sewing, knitting, drawing and painting, making, and the talent of friendship and the hands that reach out to us in the group. I thank you for all the hands that have helped me in my life and helped me to be the person I am. And I thank you for your hand. One is all. Amen.
Each of us in the Knit and Natter group work in different crafts. Some of us sew, knit, cross-stitch, make banners, paint, garden and so on. But how does this relate to God in our lives? Our God is a creative God. He's involved in all aspects of our lives, and his desire is for us to have the very best, to enjoy life in all its fullness. If God knows how many hairs are on her heads, then he will equip each of us with all with a wide and various range of skills. Over the years, I've had opportunities to try out many creative activities. Some have come more easily than others. But as a Christian, God is with me through success and not so good results. We can't compartmentalise our lives. He is with us. I have felt a skill has been gifted by God, and for me, flower arranging is a skill I've developed and find relaxing and feels like a God-given skill.
O Lord, you have searched me and known me. You know when I sit down and when I rise up. You discern my thoughts from far away. You search out my path and my lying down and are acquainted with all my ways.
Even before a word is on my tongue, O Lord, you know it completely. You hem me in, behind and before, and lay your hand upon me. Such knowledge is too wonderful for me. It is so high that I cannot attain it.
Where can I go from your spirit? Or where can I flee from your presence? If I ascend to heaven, you are there. If I make my bed in Sheol, you are there. If I take the wings of the morning and settle at the farthest limits of the sea.
Even there your hand shall lead me, and your right hand shall hold me fast. If I say, surely the darkness shall cover me, and the light around me become night. Even the darkness is not dark to you. The night is as bright as the day, for darkness is as light to you.
For it was you who formed my inward parts. You knit me together in my mother's womb. I praise you because I am fearfully and wonderfully made.
This meditation is based on Psalm 139 from the Message version. It's written in the form of a prayer from me to God. So I invite you to put yourself in place of me. Every time I speak to God, why not say in the silence how you feel? So, for example, I might say that I'm scared that God knows me so well. But you might say the opposite, that you're delighted that God knows you so well. I will leave silences for you to speak silently. Or you can pause the recording and use your own words out loud. This guided meditation is for you to take and use as suits your style of prayer. Psalm 139. God, investigate my life. Get all the facts first hand. I'm an open book to you. Ooh, that's scary, Lord. Do you really know me better than I know myself? Whoa, what have I said, Lord, that you won't like? What have I inferred, Lord, that other people are offended by? You know everything that I'm going to say. Even those things I say without thinking. I don't like that, Lord. It frightens me. Hang on, though. You're God. You love me. So you wouldn't want me to be frightened of you, surely. This psalm says you're behind me and ahead of me. Oh, that's better, Lord. So I'm never alone, then? That's much more reassuring, that no matter where I am, what I'm thinking of, or what I've said or done, you are still there, Lord. Ah, now I get it. I can be frightened. I can be worried. I can feel alone. And all of those things and more are okay. Even if none of those things are true. You are beside me, Lord, every moment, everywhere, and every day. Wow, that image, Lord, of you with giant needles, weaving, knitting, sewing, creating me, is too wonderful for me to even imagine. All my characteristics, my gifts, my whole being made in your image. Whew. I'll probably never understand why you gave me these little hands and feet. But they fit me perfectly. I don't know why I'm so sensitive, so fearful of stepping out of the doors some days, Lord. Yet you gave me my character. You taught me how to use my pain. You've taught me how to use my fears to help other people with theirs and walk alongside them as you walk alongside me. You've made me the hermit crab that I am. You've used my gifts to bring people alongside me with complementary gifts. So we work as a team. The people in my life, me and you, Lord, you've designed us to be part of each other, to support and love each other, then to go out into our communities and show other people how that knitting and sewing, weaving, crocheting, gardening and art bring love, joy,
and gifts to send others that show ordinary people your love, and that your love makes a difference to our lives in a way we never thought possible. Thank you. You're amazing, Lord. Amen.
Prayer from Susan. During this last year, with so much separation and isolation has been for our family, they wanted to make cakes, family favourites, for each one of them, so they could think about each person as they made their cake. We thank God not only for our families and friends, but also the variety of foods that God provides for us.
A prayer. Thank you, God. Thank you, God, for my precious talent that I can do when I can't go out. And for all the friends I made on Knit and Natter group. And thank you, God, for giving me patience to do my cross stitch. Amen.
Being a child in the 50s, from the age of 8, I was taught to how to sew my own clothes, something that I continued to do for many years. When I made mistakes, I would get upset, but my mum would always say, "Only God is perfect." That never consoled me. I would take out whatever I'd done wrong and try to do it better. It was the same when I learnt to knit and crochet. Whatever I did had to be the best that it could be. Later, I made costumes for many school plays. There was always something that left me feeling unsatisfied about these costumes. Then I realised it was because I wasn't using a pattern. All my life I'd envied the creative people who didn't need a pattern. But when I made things without one, I was never satisfied. Then one year, The school show was The Wizard of Oz, and because I was off work recovering from an operation, I had time to use patterns, and the old satisfaction was back. I felt that I had produced costumes that I was proud of, that the children would love to wear, and that could be a testament to God's love. It's the same in my faith life. Now that I'm using a pattern, a routine of weekly worship and fellowship, daily Bible reading and prayer, I feel so much closer to my Creator God.
John chapter 17, verses 6 to 11. I have made you known to those you gave me out of the world. They belong to you, and you gave them to me. They have obeyed your word, and now they know that everything you gave me comes from you. I gave them the message that you gave me, and they received it. They know that it is true that I came from you, and they believe that you sent me. I pray for them. I do not pray for the world, but for those you gave me, for they belong to you. All I have is yours, and all you have is mine, and my glory is shown through them. And now, I am coming to you. I am no longer in the world, but they are in the world. Holy Father, keep them safe by the power of your name, the name you gave me, so that they may be one just as you and I are one.
This passage from John's Gospel is part of what is known as the Farewell Discourse. It's part of the Gospel where Jesus tells the disciples what's going to happen over the next few days and onwards, and they struggle to understand. Jesus speaks of those who come from this world, the same world that was referred to in the often remembered, do you remember John 3:16? For God so loved the world. In the Greek, that word actually means cosmos. Cosmos, it speaks of more than people, but all that we can imagine. And people are more than just beings, but are complex, they're intricate, but they can link beautifully together. Perhaps Jesus' message was about the kingdom of heaven being that community where we are as one in God's love. Here, rather than adopting the Lord's Prayer format, Jesus prays for us. Yes, for us. Keep them safe so they can be as one, just as you and I are one. Wow, so Jesus is the one linking God and the world. Could Jesus be the one that mediates for us? Connects us, links us, weaves us together, entwines us, perhaps even knits us together. Our role is to be sent out, as Jesus said to the disciples when he came into that locked room back in, remember in Luke 24 a couple of weeks ago? We are then sent out to find opportunities to weave God's love. So amidst the mess that we might see or feel or experience today, we can intentionally be that glue to bind people, groups and communities together. Now, it might start with a few of us. It might be about something that we struggle to relate to or understand. That's me. Yeah, knitting. Nevertheless, as our focus is God's love, we can listen. And in my case, we can learn and aid conversations, both for those conversations which are audible and those which are silent. We can help to build relationships. Let's not forget that sitting with someone when they find conversations so difficult can be so helpful. In that silence, they know that they are not alone amidst all the difficulties they believe they are around. What they see as mess, they are valued. As we look around today, who are we connected to, even loosely? Those links have been stretched over the past year with this pandemic, haven't they? So now might be an appropriate time to pause, to reflect upon who might need some encouragement. Who might wish to see, to say what's on their mind, perhaps? Think of those who are not part of our church, but still so loved by God. Our connections are far greater than we can possibly imagine. Untangling everything might be beneficial with wires, but not when we desire to, is to be seen, to be woven together, for then we create something wonderfully made. And leading us into our prayers, number 518, Father, hear the prayers we offer.
Creator God, we thank you for all the gifts, characteristics and skills that you have given us to use for your glory and for supporting other people in our communities with. We come to you now, Lord, and we bring all those people, things and situations that are on our minds and we lay them before you in the silence. As we look out across your world, we ask for your healing for the people of India and all those affected by COVID. We bring before you those who are grieving, those who have lost their jobs and livelihoods. We come now, Lord, to our city of Glasgow, and we pray for the Strathclyde Circuit community and the people in our churches who are struggling to consider coming out of lockdown. As we look at this choral, Lord, which represents a community that supports each other, we ask for your wisdom and courage to support those we meet and know in our communities. May we use the gifts that you have given us to send gifts and communicate with those who are struggling.
Holy God, we also bring to you the violence in Gaza and in Jerusalem, of the attack in the Al-Aqsa Mosque, where this is not just purely Jewish and Muslims. This is humanity. These are people trying to live together and the tensions being seen in violence. We pray for this situation now, Lord.
Finally, we show your love to all we meet as we reach out to those people in our communities. In the name of Jesus, Amen. We move on in our worship, Lord, to listen to Maggie as she reads The Master Weaver.
The Master Weaver's Plan, author unknown. My life is but a weaving between the Lord and me. I may not choose the colours, he knows what they should be. For he can view the pattern upon the upper side, while I can see it only on this, the underside. Sometimes he weaveth sorrow, which seemeth strange to me. But I will trust his judgment and work on faithfully. 'Tis he who fills the shuttle and he who knows what is best. So I shall weave in earnest leaving for him the rest. Not till the loom is silent and the shuttles cease to fly, shall God unroll his canvas and explain the reason why. The dark threads are as needed in the weaver's skillful hand as the threads of gold and silver in the pattern he has planned.
And we close with a blessing. God in the clicking of the needles, God in the yarn, God in our fingers and hands, God in the intentions, God in the you, God in the weaving for the sake of your peace, God's peace in the making, Christ's peace in the giving, the Spirit's peace in the receiving. Amen, amen, amen.